Welcome back to this InvestNI tutorial on setting your business direction during the coronavirus pandemic. In this chapter, we'll show you some frameworks to help you understand your internal and external environments. This is an essential step in building an effective plan. It will help you understand where your business stands in relation to your customers, your suppliers, and your competition, and how government actions and social trends are affecting your market. In upcoming chapters, we will look at making strategic decisions. Those decisions will be based on your understanding of these factors. Scanning the external environment. PESTEL analysis. PESTEL analysis is a tried and tested way to monitor external factors and trends that may affect your business. Its name stands for political, economic, social, technological, legal, and environmental. The goal is to survey the external environment and take note of all the factors that could affect your business in each of these areas. It's a useful way of thinking through the many different forces at work. Let's look at a possible PESTEL for COVID-19. You can download a template of the PESTEL analysis from the link below this video. Political. At present, there is relative political stability. But the government is taking a lot of big decisions, and additional scrutiny of its actions will surely follow. Many countries closed their borders to the movement of people and goods. This may lead to changes in trade agreements in the medium term. Economic. The virus and the social distancing measures taken to combat it has led to a sharp recession that may be prolonged into the third and fourth quarters of 2020. Social distancing has caused many businesses to close temporarily and others to attempt to work from home, leading to reduced output, limiting supply. Inflation has stayed flat for now, but may rise if the lockdown eases. A rise in demand may come up against supply problems caused by the lockdown. Economic power was already shifting from bricks and mortar retailers to e-commerce. Social distancing measures have only quickened the pace of this transition. Social. Social distancing is having a profound effect on consumer behaviour and how we do business. Many businesses have asked their staff to work from home where possible. This shift to home working may outlive social distancing measures. Digital services of all kinds are seeing a marked increase in users, with the exception of subscription-based websites. In an effort to reduce outgoings, consumers are suspending memberships and deferring optional payments. They are also returning to shopping methods from decades ago, shopping once a week and buying only the essentials. The global tourism industry stopped abruptly. Travelers may be wary of venturing overseas for fear that a new outbreak of COVID-19 may leave them stranded. People who work in service industries and hospitality have been hit particularly hard by the pandemic. Unemployment may see their income decline more, further limiting consumer spending. Technological. Digital businesses see opportunities in the pandemic, while other industries are adapting their offerings to the online environment. A greater need to protect workers in manufacturing environments will give a boost to automation. New technologies are being developed to fight the pandemic, not least a host of treatments for the infection itself. Legal. Government's role in responding to the crisis to support business has included the requisition of protective equipment, increased fiscal support, and guarantee of public services. The long-term result may be greater regulation of all sorts of industries. Environmental. There is a renewed focus on health and safety in physical and remote workplaces. Alongside physical health, more attention is being paid to the mental health of workers forced to work from home. Oil demand has slumped dramatically, prompting a rethink of the resources businesses need to operate. Meanwhile, a reduction in air pollution has provided a silver lining to an otherwise grim time. Will the pandemic accelerate the shift towards a low-carbon economy? Explore the effect of external factors like these on your business and complete your template. Revisit them from time to time. Are they changing? SWOT analysis. Using PESTEL offers you a complete picture of the external environment. However, these tools don't take the internal aspects of your business into account. A SWOT analysis can help. A SWOT analysis helps you to build on your strengths, minimize your weaknesses, identify opportunities, and avoid threats. Download the SWOT analysis template at the link below this video. Fill in the template with your weaknesses and strengths as we progress. Threats and opportunities. Threats and opportunities are the factors that we examined in the PESTEL analysis. Threats may include a changing political, legal, and regulatory environment, social influences such as changes in customers' buying behavior, new entrants in your industry, the recession's effects on the economy, or supply chain disruptions. However, your business might identify opportunities such as emerging needs for your products and services, collaborations with other businesses, more room to maneuver under relaxed legal frameworks, a new problem to solve, or the ability to localize your supply chain. Weaknesses and strengths. Your strengths and weaknesses are internal to your organization. We identified these in stage one of the business response model. Weaknesses may include processes that are not working well at present, technology that is out of date or not fit for purpose, cash flow issues, a lack of scenario planning, or effective supply chain management. Your strengths may include skilled staff and experienced central team, technology and know-how, tangible assets such as machinery and tools, or the ability to offer digital services. We have explored some ways of learning about your internal and external environment. In the next chapter, we'll focus on what you can do with this information. See you there.